In this video, I'm going to discuss the most important multiple choice questions about bryophytes, which comes in different competitive exams of biology. Liyaza apne is video ko start se lekar end tak pura dekhna hai taki ye questions aapko achhi tarah taiyar ho jaye. To chaliye dosto shuru karte hain aaj ki video. Question number 1. The amphibian of plant kingdom are pteridophytes, bryophytes, gymnosperms, angiosperms. So correct answer is option B. Bryophytes are considered as amphibians of plant kingdom because they live on the land and need water for their fertilization. Question number 2. The first land inhabitant plants are pteridophytes, bryophytes, gymnosperms, angiosperms. So correct answer is option B. Bryophytes are first land inhabitant plants. Question number 3. Bryophytes are differ from pteridophytes in being non-vascular, seeded, vasculature, saprophytic. So correct answer is option A. Bryophytes are different from the pteridophytes in being non-vasculature, means they have no vascular tissues, xylem and phloem. Question number 4. Connecting tissue in bryophytes is made of xylem and phloem, xylem, collenchyma only, parenchyma. So correct answer is option D. The connecting tissue in case of bryophytes are made of parenchyma cells. Next question ki taraf jane se pehle meri aapse darkhwast hai ki agar aapne abhi tak is channel ko subscribe nahi kiya to please subscribe kar lein aur saath hi maujood bell icon ko bhi lazmi press kar dein. Question number 5. Which is true about bryophytes? Heterophytes, mesophytes, scyophytes, xerophytes. So correct answer is option C. Bryophytes are considered as scyophytes. Scyophytes means they prefer to live in moist, shady and wet places. So correct answer is option C. Question number 6. Fertilization in bryophytes is performed by isogamy, anisogamy, zooidogamy, cytogamy. So correct answer is option C. The fertilization in bryophytes is performed by zooidogamy. The zooidogamy is a process of fertilization in which motile sperm swims towards the eggs to fertilize it. So zooidogamy is the process that occurs in bryophytes. Question 7. The spore mother cells in bryophytes are haploid, diploid, triploid, tetraploid. So correct answer is option B. The spore mother cell in bryophytes is diploid in nature and it undergoes meiosis process to form haploid spores. Question number 8. Bryophytes flourish in moist and shady environments because they cannot grow on land, they lack vascular tissue, they lack root and stomata, their gametes fuse in water. So correct answer is option D. Bryophytes flourished in moist and shady environments because their gametes fuse in water. It means they need water for their fertilization. Question number 9. Gametophyte generation is dominant in pteridophytes, bryophytes, gymnosperms, angiosperms. So correct answer is option B. Gametophyte generation is dominant in case of bryophytes, and this gametophyte generation is also haploid in nature. नेक्स्ट क्वेश्चन की तरफ जाने से पहले अगेन मेरी आपसे दरख्वास्त है कि अगर आपने अभी तक इस चैनल को सब्सक्राइब नहीं किया तो प्लीज़ सब्सक्राइब कर लें और साथ ही मौजूद बेल आइकॉन को भी लास्ट में प्रेस कर दें. क्वेश्चन नंबर 10, जर्मिनेशन ऑफ स्पोर्स इज इनडायरेक्ट इन क्लास हेपाटिकोप्सिडा, एंथोसिरोटोप्सिडा, ब्रायोप्सिडा, ऑल ऑफ दिस. सो करेक्ट आंसर इज ऑप्शन सी, द जर्मिनेशन ऑफ स्पोर्स इज indirect in class Bryophyta, which include different mosses. The germination of spores is indirect, means spores does not germinate directly into the gametophyte, rather they form multicellular structures that is known as protonema. Question number 11, which is wrong in respect to bryophytes? Water is essential for fertilization. Presence of archegonia, presence of ciliated sperms, presence of autotrophic independent sporophyte. So correct answer is option D, the presence of autotrophic independent sporophyte is wrong concept about bryophytes, because bryophytes have sporophyte that is dependent on gametophyte for food, water and habitat. Question number 12, sporophyte is attached to gametophyte by means of stalk, foot, apophysis, root. So correct answer is option B, foot is the part of sporophyte through which sporophyte is attached to the gametophyte. So correct answer is option B. Question 13, the protonema is a stage in the life cycle of Rhizia, Funaria, all bryophytes, Cycas. So correct answer is option B, protonema is a stage that is formed in the life cycle of mosses such as Funaria. Protonema is a multicellular structure that is formed from the spores and further it is developed into the but so this protonema formation is a strategy in order to survive. Question number 14, which is not an example of class Hepaticopsida, Mercantia, Purilla, Rhizia, Anthoceros. So correct answer is option D, Anthoceros is not an example of class Hepaticopsida or liverworts, because Anthoceros belongs to class Anthoceratopsida. Question 15, sporophyte of liverworts is composed of foot, seta, capsule, all of these. So correct answer is option D, the sporophyte of liverworts or hepaticopsida is composed of foot, seta and capsule. Question number 16, true elaters are present in Mercantia, Purilla, Rhizia, Sphagnum. So correct answer is option A, true elaters are present in Mercantia plants that belongs to class Hepaticopsida or liverworts. These true elaters are used in dispersal of spores. Question number 17, which is absent in the sporophyte of hornworts? Foot is absent, seta is absent, capsule is absent, all are present. So correct answer is option B, seta is absent in the sporophyte of hornworts. So correct answer is option B. Question 18, sporophyte is not completely dependent on gametophyte in liverworts, hornworts, mosses, both A and B. So correct answer is option B as well as option C, because in both hornworts and mosses, sporophyte is not completely dependent on gametophyte, Rather, sporophyte has photosynthetic tissue, so it can prepare food for itself, so it only depends on gametophyte for water and habitat. So correct answer must be option B as well as option C. Question number 19. Asexual reproduction by gamma formation occurs in hepaticopsida, anthoceratopsida, bryopsida, all of these. So correct answer is option A. Asexual reproduction by gamma formation. Gamma or gamae are actually multicellular asexual green colored birds that are present in class hepaticopsida or liverworts. नेक्स्ट क्वेश्चन की तरफ जाने से पहले अगेन मेरी आपसे दरख्वास्त है कि अगर आपने अभी तक इस चैनल को सब्सक्राइब नहीं किया तो प्लीज़ सब्सक्राइब कर लें और साथ ही मौजूद बेल आइकॉन को भी लास्ट में प्रेस कर दें. क्वेश्चन नंबर 20. विच ऑफ द फॉलोइंग लिवरवर्ट्स इज डायोशियस. डायोशियस मीन्स इन विच ड्यूरिंग सेक्शुअल रिप्रोडक्शन मेल एंड फीमेल ऑर्गन्स सेक्स ऑर्गन्स आर फॉर्म्ड ऑन द सेम प्लांट. इन केस ऑफ मर्केंशिया, पुरीला, रिशिया, ऑल आर मोनोशियस. सो करेक्ट आंसर इज ऑप्शन ए. मर्केंशिया इज अ लिवरवर्ट्स दैट इज डायोशियस इन नेचर. क्वेश्चन नंबर 21. क्लास ब्रायोप्सिडा इंक्लूड लिवरवर्ट्स, हॉर्नवर्ट्स, मोसेस, ऑल ऑफ दीज. सो करेक्ट आंसर इज ऑप्शन सी. Class Bryophytes include mosses such as Pioneeria and Sphagnum moss. Question number 22. Spore dispersal in hornworts took place by triulators, pseudoilators, peristomial teeth, none of these. So correct answer is option B. Spore dispersal in hornworts took place by means of pseudoilators. Also remember that the spore dispersals in liverworts took place by triulators, while the spore dispersals in case of mosses took place by means of peristomial teeth. So in current situation, the spore dispersals in hornworts took place by pseudoilators. Question number 23. Simplest sporophyte is present in Mercantia, Purilla, Rishia, Sphagnum. So correct answer is option C. The sporophyte of Rishia is the simplest sporophyte ever because it is composed of only capsule. Question number 24. Presence of leaf-like structure of gametophyte is unique character of class Hepaticopsida, class Anthoceratopsida, class Bryophytes, all of these. So correct answer is option C. The presence of leaf-like structure of gametophyte is a unique character of class Bryophytes or mosses because mosses are the first plants ever in which there is presence of leaf-like structures in the gametophyte in whole plant kingdom. Question 25. Multicellular rhizoids are present in liverworts, hornworts, mosses, all of these. So correct answer is option C. Multicellular rhizoids are present in mosses and these rhizoids are root-like structures that are present in the sporophyte. Question 26. Venter is a xylem portion of sporogonium, sporangium, anthridium, archegonium. So correct answer is option D. The venter is a xylem portion of archegonium and these venters encloses the egg. Question number 27. The last stage of male gametophyte generation is spores, spore mother cells, zygote, gametes. So correct answer is option D. The last stage of gametophyte generation is formation of gametes. Question number 28. Which of the following is true moss? Club moss, reindeer moss, iris moss, bog moss. So correct answer is option D. Bog moss is a true moss. It is also known as sphagnum moss. Question number 29. Which of the following has considerable economic importance? Mercantia, purilla, ricea, sphagnum. So correct answer is option D. Sphagnum moss has considerable economic importance because it is used as a fuel and it is also used to colonize the different rocks. So it breaks the rocks and makes them stable for cultivation. So correct answer is option D. Sphagnum has great economic importance. Question 30. In bryophytes, the entheridia are monoflagellate, biflagellate, multiflagellate, all of these. So correct answer is option B. In case of bryophytes, the entheridia are biflagellate and they are motile and move towards the archegonia and fertilizes the egg. So correct answer is option B. So ye the 30 most important questions about phylum Bryophyta or Bryophytes. Agar video aapko pasand aayi hai to please is channel ko like karein, subscribe karein aur saath hi maujood bell icon ko bhi lazmi taur par press kar dein taki is tarah ki latest video ka notification aapko aage bhi milta rahe.